Is admission done?
Ma'am, we are live. We can start.
Yes, please. I'm not able to load the PowerPoint because give me a minute. It's not able to enlarge itself. I will not be able to read it. 1 minute. It's ridiculous. So, which is that space control, is it, when it doesn't enlarge itself? Ah, it's done. Okay. Good morning, prospective parents and students. It's a pleasure on behalf of Symbiosis Law School Pune, which is the premier law school in India, and Symbiosis International University, to which this law school is a constituent, to welcome all of you. A very good morning to each and every one of you. It's our pleasure here to be joined by some of the important stakeholders of our institute, representing our parents, representing the alumni milieu, and the faculty members who are in the forefront of running this institution, along with me as team members. As we unveil before you why we hail or commend you on your decision of joining this law school or trying to join this law school, we would also like to share with you some of the important highlights of how this law school has remained constantly among the top 10 law schools of the country, where we have almost 1,200 odd law colleges, law teaching institutes, and law universities in the country, making it into a very big lot. So consistently since 2000, we have maintained this enviable position. But that hasn't been very easy. It has been possible only because of the consistent reviews, the constant attention that we give to our students, and individual mentoring that we aim at, and the constant support of alumni and students. Who's this? So Amit, I would suggest that we have all videos of the people till we finish the presentation, okay? Videos, yes, of the audiences and others, except the panel member videos. Yeah. Okay, let me continue. So this is the law school which represents a sort of what we call as classic excellence. Why do we call it classic? What is classic? Classic is something that is unweathered by time. And this law school represents that kind of excellence in creating profession-ready lawyers or profession-ready professionals. Why I say profession-ready and why classic excellence? See, this is one of the very few law schools in the country which has been there for a long time. This was created in 1977 as the second law school in Pune. Till then, for 75 years, we had only one law school in Pune, ILS Law College. And today we have about nearly 20 law colleges in Pune. So Symbiosis Law School Pune has been a front runner in legal education in Pune. And it has also been greeted with a lot of support in the very first year. We started with a 3-year law course, as the custom then was, but We were greeted in the very first year with 3,000 applications for the 300 seats. So our journey has been a journey in success and excellence from the beginning, unweathered by time. And we have created profession-ready lawyers or profession-ready professionals because we are not only looking at, we make every student capable of standing up and talking and advocating. It could be a cause, it could be for justice, but at the same time, we have given them a diverse career possibility. One of our parents, Mr. Anup Kumar, is going to highlight how his son embarked on the journey like all other students and mastered the art of advocacy by the time he was in fourth year, interning and helping in legal aid and community legal service, undergoing internationalization. But then he's embarking on a very unique career, which let him talk, I would not like to preempt. So this is how we encourage those diversity of careers while ensuring that the professional values of using the knowledge and skills for public service, which is ingrained in a lawyer's profession, in a very systematic, structured, and a carefully worked out, what we call as in a very, very carefully worked out, systematic way of imparting student development, where the students set the goal in the very first year, and then those students go on to verify through their internships, through their grades, and then they identify goal A, goal B, goal C, or plan A, plan B, plan C, carefully mentored by the faculty, where each faculty takes care of at least 10 students from every batch. Overall, we, each one of us, including myself, take care of about 50 to 60 students in a year, and we closely monitor their development. So some of these best practices make us consistently to be among the top 5, top 10 law schools of this country. And we are the topmost law school in the private sector consistently in JHRDC survey, India Today survey, and other surveys. And even in the Government of India's NIRF, we have been figuring in the top 10 law school list despite being in the private sector or in addition to being a private sector strong law school. So our university's tagline, if you see, it comes from the Upanishadic saying of a great sage, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, which means the whole world is one family. In symbiosis, when a student enters, the student feels that the student belongs to the world and student is going to aim at careers which are valid throughout the world. That is the method of training that we have. So our founder and chancellor, Dr. S.B. Muzumdar sir, who was a botany professor and a PhD in microbiology, when he created this as the very first higher education institute within the symbiosis banner, which was initially created to bring Indian and foreign students together, put this tagline of promoting international understanding through quality education. We customized that tagline to the legal education, let us say, a meditation or yagna that we do here, calling it as promoting international understanding through quality legal education and research, combining what we call as the four C's. What are those four C's? Care, courage, competence, and collaboration. So we will unveil before you, let's go to the next slide. How do we represent this care, courage, competence, and collaboration? Now, before we unveil that, we would request you to listen to it from our students' authentic testimonial. So let's play the video where the students are talking.
Greetings from the Symbiosis Law School family.
A very warm welcome to the potential batch of 2021 to Symbiosis Law School family.
We are the student cabinet and we are here to assure you of a friendly atmosphere,
academic competence, and extracurricular talent that SLS fosters.
We are here to offer a glimpse into SLS Pune's vibrant student.
We are excited to have you with us and wish you all the very best.
Symbiosis Law School Pune was established in 1977 and has since been the pinnacle of legal education in this country, the students of this institution have been incredibly fortunate to have had the opportunity to be trained and guided by a distinguished faculty who have always had their doors open for any student in need. Symbiosis fosters an environment where students are given ample opportunities to learn and excel in any field of their choice. Our professors invest a lot of their time and energy into our academic development, being our mentor and guiding us closely at every step of the way. Our faculty are our biggest cheerleaders, and they try and do everything in their power to see us emerge successful. Apart from our incredible teaching staff, we have an amazing library. Symbiosis strives to provide its students with a holistic development program, and it has definitely allowed me to explore and showcase my talents. This college has been a home away from home for me, and I am honored to graduate under the banner of Symbiosis.
The college strives to provide to each and every student a holistic learning environment, and therefore encourages participation and excellence in extracurricular and co-curricular activities along with the prescribed academia. We participate in various events such as national and international moot court competitions, writing papers for renowned journals, publishing them and presenting them in national conferences. We participate in various public speaking events such as Model United Nations, parliamentary debates, and also take on extra credit courses outside of the prescribed curriculum. All of this is possible because of the excellent facilities, the brilliant faculty, the well-established peer system, a brilliant network of alumni, and everything put together, Symbiosis provides you with the platform which you require in order to harness your potential. Right from our first interaction with our seniors during our first day of college, which is 0 day, to during our intra-college festival symptoms, and later on during our academic and extracurricular activities. Be it our internals, moot court competitions, or even our committee bonding sessions, our seniors have been our mentors and guides and have now become our forever buddies and who have made our city, Pune, home to us. At Symbiosis Law School, Pune, we also have the Buddy Student Peer Assistance System, which facilitates such bonding activities between seniors and juniors and also promotes internationalization along with promoting unity and harmony.
I joined Symbiosis in 2016 after completing my schooling from DPS Arkipuram, Delhi. When I came to Pune, I was a little apprehensive about the new place, completely different surroundings, new city, new professors, new classmates, and above all, ragging. However, when I came to Symbiosis, all these doubts were gone. Not even for a second, I felt like an outsider. Ragging was nowhere to be seen. Instead, the ambience was full of friendly and cheerful seniors. To be honest, this has been a tradition at Symbiosis. Even we, as seniors, as well as being the member of SAB, would be more than happy to help you out in whatever way we can.
Well, of course, college has given us all numerous memories, but holistically speaking, one of the most remarkable memories from college life is the work for Simba, when as a college delegation, we had gone to Mumbai to invite some legal luminaries. Just because of the sheer confidence that the college has imbibed in us through this constant support of our college faculty and seniors alike, we were able to take initiatives that many while starting out think are beyond reach. But thanks to our college, we were able to individually interact with legal behemoths ranging from judges of the Supreme Court of India to legal stalwarts such as Mr. Shardul Shroff, Mr. Hegreef Khaitan, and Mr. Lakshmi Kumaran. Not only has it been an extremely enlightening experience, but it has been a great motivation and a booster since the college has trusted us and enabled us to pull off such feats by giving us so much freedom and having faith in us. Hope you all get these opportunities very soon.
One second, Mr. Amit, Could we pause the video? Because the video doesn't seem to be running smoothly.
Through an integrated buddy system, students are connected with mentors in senior batches who can guide them in their academic endeavors.
Amit, can we pause the video, please? Can we pause the video? Yeah. I'm sorry, parents and all others and our organizing team. There has been some technical glitch, it seems like. There is no point in continuing something where there is a lot of interruption in reception. So let me continue with the story. Now, I know that some of you are saying that we already know how great this law school is. We would like to ask our questions. We have been keeping a watch on your questions, but we will also request you to hold on because, you know, there are many things which a website doesn't say, which all those student testimonials after they get into the profession, where you might have been motivated by some professionals and others you have come across as our alumni, do not say. That is why we thought our existing students who are in the leadership of what we call a student advisory board to the college governance should speak to you. And I'm sure that this would have given you a lot of clarity. None of these students came in the way they were, and they turned out to be that confident, that owning up, and that professional as they were training themselves in fully engaging with the college life. So I personally feel, along with my team, that it's very important to tell you these things in order to see that when your ward gets qualified, you will stand by your ward and encourage him or her to fully engage in the college life. I have seen many parents, after they admit, they come back only when there is a problem, or if the student achieves, most of our students are cream, the cream of Indian student community. So they have a tendency to think that, okay, this achievement is anyway there, our child is an achiever. The fact that they made to Symbiosis Law School among 25,000 applicants itself is a huge achievement. No, our duty as parents only changes and it doesn't stop. So now there is the next slide, which introduces my own background in the forefront of this institute. Shall we run that slide? Who is running the slide? So this CV shows that I have come here with a full round experience ranging from community legal service, full-time teaching I started my career in my hometown. Then I was invited to join National Law School as an assistant professor at a very young age, as the very first woman professor to get a tenure within no time of joining. But then I moved to Ireland, and from Ireland, I came back, took a corporate assignment in the Middle East as well. So I have a full experience of industry, academia, research, and practice, but practicing without any fee for the poor litigants. So this is overall, bird's eye view of how I lead this and why I lead this institute. But after coming here, I got good opportunities as a Fulbright scholar, participated with the government, because once you are a professional, especially you are a lawyer, you cannot imagine your life without governance and government. We and governance are friends. And you know how the police also look at lawyers as a kind of love-hate relationship. That's because we are the ones who, you would have seen that even during COVID, the public interest litigation was first mooted by a lawyer in the first wave. So this is how our profession is a very unique profession, where I bring those skill sets to the table. And our faculty members also in a way resonate some of these skill sets. Collectively, we are having that multiplier effect. Let's go to the next slide quickly. Next slide, please. So, recently we were very, very honored to have the Higher Education Excellence Award in internationalization. We were competing with technology college, medical colleges, and all other kinds of colleges. But for a law college to get this is a huge achievement, because law is always bound up with national governance and all other accolades you all are aware of. But the most important one is, globally, topmost law firm is Hubbard Smith Freehills. If anyone is looking at these law firms, then they would think you have to be in a government-based law school and things like that. No, It is our students' work with the prisoners, with the poor in the community legal service, which when it was documented won an award, because of which Herbert Smith Freehills Law Firm chose our institute as a training ground of future lawyers in certain lawyering skills. So we had Oxford and other professors coming and training our students along with a few selected from other law schools. Now our strengths are our internationalization, our robust research culture, which my faculty is going to highlight both of these, and how we focus on career and professional development, as I told you, preparing our students to multiple career options by giving skills input. We are the only law school which has a well-structured skills center and ADR center. And we also have a career and professional development cell. We don't call it placement cell because placement is one offshoot, but what is important is making them employable and showing them the right way, how they can plan it, sequence it, and choose between options available. Very much keeping in touch with the way the young people change their brainwave as they grow. And minimum of 2 to 3 career shifts that everyone goes through in their life. So we have very scientifically developed approaches taken up by this. And our robust community outreach program, as I told you, in the Aravada prison, in the Pune red light area, in 27 villages where our university medical college and our university outreach program is reaching the medical aid, we are having the legal aid. Let's go to the next slide. Now, that way you will see that this law school is so strong that we have care towards the community. You see there retired Justice Chalumeshwar as one of the speakers in just last weekend's mooting competition, which was an international competition. So we care for the community. We have the courage to stand up and question. We develop competencies in students and faculty. So our project Eurasia is one of the unique projects in the country where we developed more than 28 courses and introduced a specialization in European Legal Studies in LLM. So a student who enters this college will get to learn in 2 streams, either human rights stream or trade law stream, something on European Union legal studies. So it's a mandatory part of our curriculum. And then we also create justice defenders. Our students work in all our projects related to community. Our projects, we have 6 European projects. And in these projects, we have to the tune of 3 crore grants. And in most of these projects, students get the opportunity to interact, to contribute. Just yesterday, we sent a report to Supreme Court on e-justice project, recommending certain changes or certain new avenues. So we were invited to do that kind of research. So this shows that we are a law school, which is in the private sphere, but having the kind of telling effect and impacting through our research and expertise, all the layers of India and world. So we have that what we call as world-class spirit of collaboration, upholding the rule of law through various institutions and avenues of justice work, not just law, but justice work. Let's go to the next slide. So this shows you the different ranking. You are already thorough with that. That's why I know that some of you are saying, why should we go through these details? There is a reason. Let's go ahead. So it is not to beat our breast and say that we are so great. It is rather to be humbly submit before you the data which you may not see in the mainstream communication avenues, and to be authentically communicating to you why and how your ward should be prepared to get into this law school. Let's go to the next slide. We have many students, almost 40 students who have qualified as judges in different judiciary across the country. 4 of our alumni are sitting judges of Mumbai High Court in different benches. And we have some of our alumni who are our Saurabh as additional advocate general, and Ravneet, who recently passed out but became the judge, in clearing her judicial services exam in Haryana. We have, next slide. We have a few who are in IRS. We have a few who have cleared civil service last year as well. So if you quickly look at our fact sheet, we have 39 plus another 39 who are our distinguished visiting faculty, like Mr. Anup, who is a parent and who is also a great authority on Farm Bill and many other developmental avenues with his master's abroad. 2 masters abroad. So we have programs like BLL Be Honors, BBLL Be Honors, where you are the aspirants. Then we have the three-year LLB, LLM, diploma program. But I must tell you, our eyes are BALLB and BBLLB Honors program. Our BBLLB Honors program is unique in the country. We were one of the first few to open this kind of a program other than Jodhpur National Law School. But we were, Jodhpur Law School came into existence about 2000, whereas we were having BBLLB program way back, you know. So this is where we are a kind of pioneering institute in the country. Even 1 year LLM, only 4 institutes started in India. We were one of the first. Our 3 year LLB products, 3 year LLB aspirants are comparable to IIT Kharagpur's IP LLB specialization program. We currently have some full-time scholars, 65 plus international collaborations. We have publications which are to the tune of about 500, including Scopus publications, almost 50 plus. And European Union Legal Studies is very unique. We were the first in the country to start this certificate program. And today it has matured into master's specialization. Asian Legal Studies is it is already offered. One batch has taken it and the next one will be offered this year again. Certificate programs are also continuing. Scholars in Residence, we have had a number of people which will be shown later quickly. So we have about, as you see there, 1,958 students, almost 2,000 students housed in this campus quickly. Next slide, please. So these are the snapshots of our international program. Our own research program is now seeing the conference, which is held all over the world, which represent with representation from across the continents. It has seen its 9th avatar with the unique international track and participation over 1,000 people, 80 abstracts, 60 papers, and a lot of input for our innovative curricula coming from the conference where we get a lot of resource persons and contributors. Let's go to the next one. We were one of the first in the world to start this rule of law theme in the conference, followed by National University of Singapore just last 2 years. We had a very unique contribution this year made to the Ministry of Home Affairs, where once again, we were invited by the minister to give our special views on the transformation of the criminal justice system in India. We gave more than 300 page kind of report covering all the aspects. And you see a celebrity prosecutor, Mr. Ujjwal Nikam, as one of the panelists among others. Quick one, please. We have the Chancellor here inaugurating our Indo-Canadian Shastri Institute grant-supported international lecture series, where we had, again, representatives from the UN, representatives from Canada, America, and Europe, and many countries, aside from experts in the field of environment and law. It is mainly on right to breathe clean air. And this was a competitive grant. Quickly. So like this, we had just last weekend, another very important roundtable discussion on under-trial prisoners and delayed justice, which was the idea given by Mr. Srijan Pal Singh, who is a social activist, and picked up by our Honorable Chancellor. So this also was greeted with huge success with the organization of Dr. Kiran Bedi and others coming in as collaborators in this event. So we are very happy to posit before you how we have kept our quality and added on. And now we don't have to work much because people have seen such trustworthy, credible asset of knowledge and resources and expertise in us that they offer to collaborate with us. That's what you saw, that year and year on, we have continued our journey of excellence in a classic manner. Now I hand over the podium to our two stakeholders. First of all, I request Mr. Anup Kumar to come on call and address our prospective parents and students. Over to you, sir. And then
thank you, ma'am. I thank Symbiosis Law School to give me this opportunity to share my experiences as a parent and also as one of the stakeholders in the growth of this college with all of you. So I would like to start with this, that Symbiosis Law College initially is not the first choice, and we inspired our son Avichal, to go for any of the national universities, and we were pushing him for everything in CLAT. It was just about the chance that we visited Pune. I came here for some official work, and then I decided to check in both the colleges, which one, as ma'am mentioned, the oldest law school, that is ILS Law College, and Symbiosis. So first we went there. So he saw, he interacted. I knew many of the faculty members there. And then we came to Symbiosis, and something happened there. First, we wanted to, the director, we wanted to check the overall environment. We could get an audience with ma'am. And then we asked Avichal to explore and give his feedback. And we'll entirely go by his feedback, his choice. So after spending some two and a half hours there, he said, I am not appearing in CLAT and I am going for Symbiosis. We asked him why. He said, there's something very vibrant in this college, something which triggers me, something which makes me feel that I can realize my potential here. He said that I like the overall friendliness, warmth, facilitation, the kind of, the seniors were there to guide him what is there. He met some of the younger, second year, third year student. They all were willing to share. They were smiling, they were friendly. There's something which made him realize that this is a place where I want to come, because it was his will to realize the potential he has. And not necessarily he was very keen to become a professional lawyer. Means he hadn't that time unfolded in his mind what exactly he wants to, but he must be keeping it somewhere deep inside. But he said he will join the college. And since then, it has been a journey of self-discovery and, realizing one's potential. So, of course, he is our single child. And I must confess that initial settlement in the new ecosystem of living all by his own, because he was being a single child, we had taken a very good care. So living alone and living in an environment which is totally unfamiliar. So there were jitters, there were issues of settling, because, Symbiosis has a hostel for female students, but does not have a hostel for male students. So it was jumping from one accommodation to other. Finally, he could settle. But once he settled, there were no issues, because he was totally absorbed with the kind of culture where academic inputs were as important as co-curricular, extracurricular, and growing together, growing with peers, assimilating a lot from the environment, from the peers. So this actually made him quite immersed with that kind of ecosystem. It was not at all examination-centric system in which they will be given dry inputs and asked to learn them, mug them, and appear in exam. No. The whole learning was through certain process. The process was understanding the entire legal system by variety of interactions, the interactions with the luminaries, the experts who will come to address them in various seminars, conferences, then moot courts where the issues will be selected carefully so that they get exposed and they are inspired to go for self-learning, a lot of self-reading. So this kind of academic ecosystem, which kind of believes in the student's inherent capacity to go for imbibing knowledge and making part of their existence, part of their value system. This was something which we realized when as ma'am talked about four C's, the care, courage, competence, and collaboration. I will add another C, that is compassion. The compassion my son had towards working for the marginalized section of society are those who need legal aid or who need kind of assistance and facilitation. That was tremendous. So initially, as I was telling, he was brought up in a very secured environment, having interactions with a lot of other fellow students. He was little introvert, having solitary and loneliness kind of thing, and will not talk much. The same Avichal, in second and third year, when he was asked to go for internships, he will select the areas of internship. Again, without any intervention, he won't allow me or his mother to intervene in what his preference and choices. And then he went for teaching the orphan students who were in a school called Abhyuday Global School, which was for former suicide victims' children, where either both parents are dead or the mother is not in position to teach the child. The child will be picked up from those four or five districts of Vidarbha, and they will be brought to that resident school. He went there, and his entire 3 months of his internship, he taught them. He taught them not only English, but basically kind of whatever their learning need was. They were students of third and fourth grade. So we never knew that he has a pedagogical skill. We never knew that he can teach, but he not only taught, he became so close to them. Many of them remained in touch, and in all the functions of Abhyuday, Avichal will be called by the organizers to speak to the students. Then later stages, he joined another NGO on internship to work for gender justice and all those issues where the laws are still evolving. It may be Domestic Violence Act and all other acts related to gender justice. And then he was asked to do a survey, which was a very complex survey about sexual harassment at workplace. And I was surprised. He will see no barriers. He will go to any extent to pursue the kind of questionnaires which was given by the NGO head. And he had no hesitation to ask this question straight to the women employees of the organization he will visit. Have you ever experienced sexual harassment in workplace? Many of them were not keen to fill the this thing, but he will facilitate. He said, we are not going to share your name, but please do narrate your experience. So this is the kind of courage and compassion he developed out of his external exposures. I think that has come because of a basic internalization, which exposes them to a global learning environment. So I'm actually very thankful to the guidance of Director Ma'am, Dr. Godpur, and her faculty colleagues who had inspired him to apply for summer schools. So two of the summer school which he could attend, he was selected in those, one at University of Berlin, the Law Faculty of Berlin University, and second later on in Ireland. It changed him completely. It was a transformative kind of development in his personality, because he developed so much of confidence, so much of self-belief and trust, his own creating his own network on his own, on a global kind of journey. I remember we didn't know how he's going to visit London from a faraway place in Ireland. He, he took a bus journey, he took a steamer journey, and then a train journey to reach to London to one of our relatives. And we never knew at age of 20, he is competent enough to explore the world. But this is the kind of confidence building which happens because encouragement to the self-realization, working in lateral groups. For example, he went for a national level inter-college cricket match to Kolkata, all by train, and on the way, so much of integration took place because there were many, he was in second year only, and whereas most of the team members were from fourth year, fifth year. So much of team building he could do. And then he also realized that world is not that innocent as he perceives world to be. So he started kind of understanding that we should not be judging people by their external ambience, how they look, their appearance, but by the belief and value systems. So that discerning skill to understand human character, that also he got due to the extracurricular and co-curricular activity. As far as academic inputs are concerned, I must say, as he narrates to us, it has been more or less a culture of facilitation when they are asked to do a lot of reading of quality reading material and then ask questions. So the inquisitive spirit of a student is encouraged a lot. And I must say, that's how he has learned this quality of questioning. He will question now his parents, his mother, his father, and whatever inputs we give to him towards how he should conduct. So he will question. Sometimes it annoys. Sometimes it makes you feel that how come at this stage when he should be an obedient young man saying yes to, he questioned. So, but this spirit of that before accepting anything, he should be questioning and he should be analyzing and understanding. And only after he's convinced, he should accept it. So this quality of questioning comes because of the overall ethos of college, where whenever faculty speaks, 20-25 minutes are given to all students to raise their doubts, their question, interjections. And that spirit of inquiry makes a student register the presence felt. So the student absorbs the whatever inputs are delivered and then they ask questions. So when I spoke on form bill, I remember having received questions which even I fumbled to answer because they were so razor sharp. So this razor sharp queries and questions come only because there is a competition. There is a competition that who registers the presence better. And this, I think this competition, it is a competition for competence. It is a competition for excellence. And this kind of competition keeps them on their toes, sometimes little annoyed, sometimes little jittery, but helps them to settle with the best from what they could get from a college. Another thing which I would like, that's the last thing I would like to narrate, is that my son was not, as I said in the beginning, not very keen to become a lawyer. He wanted to explore a different, so later on he revealed it only after he was very interactive. There was a session held by Dr. Gurpur ma'am herself on civil aviation laws. And he asked a lot of very informed questions, and he later on met ma'am, and ma'am realized that the boy has a potential to go for a aviation law and aerospace law kind of course, which was not available in, there was some, this full-fledged course or a specialization was not available in Symbiosis. So ma'am facilitated him joining online course in NALSAR, Hyderabad on this. And not only that, she herself spoke to the dean, who was so helpful. He is one of the authorities. Dr. Reddy is one of the authority on aviation law. So in last 1 year, he has completely diversified himself, and from a professional law practitioner to having to choose a career from law, he has gone for a diversified career that is in aviation and air transport management. And I'm happy to inform all the parents here that the kind of exposure he had, the kind of recommendation he had. Now, 4 of the UK universities have given him offer to join 1 year MSc in aviation law or air transport management, all due to, the facilitation which the college gives, which triggers the students to realize the potential and also to pursue the kind of their inane, very inherent dream, the dream which is suppressed because the world at large tells them to go for a structured courses and structured careers. But the boy could go for a diversified career because the college itself facilitates that. And I'm very grateful to Dr. Gurpu ma'am and the college faculty who have helped him to go on a path of self-realization and discovery of his choice, of his mooring, of the thing which he wants to do. You know, many of us in our life land up in careers and later on realize that, oh, we wanted to do something else. So that is the generation of past. The new generation is too smart and too assertive. They assert their dream, they assert their aspiration. And I'm happy to tell you that the college encourages that kind of assertion. So this is what, from my personal experience, I wish all the parents to think of this before they send their ward to law college, that what exactly he or she wants to become. And only means if they feel the ward is not very sure, they can send them with that confidence that college will help them in realizing what the dreams they had, what they wanted to become. Thank you so much.
A lot of gratitude for sharing honest feedback, sir. I would like to appeal to the parents that don't be scared. Your wards will have enough seats in the first year in the hostel. As the things go, students like to be independent at this age. So first years, we provide them hostel. Our own hostels, there are large numbers now. In the last 2 years, we have created such accommodation. And under our relationship, in the sense that our close scrutiny, we have other hostels also listed. Other than that, what is most important is, as you study law, down the years, somewhere you discover something about your culture, and we encourage that. Aim at making our students profoundly developed. Thank you, sir, for your humility. You have also been strongly associated with the college, and most of our parents are partners in our success. If you want your ward to do well, whichever college your ward gets into, engage in that college in a very decent and non-interfering way, like how Mr. Anu said. Now, I would request our alumna who has come back to educate himself again with us, despite his successful stint, Mr. Rahul Kothari, to come.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Dr. Gurpur, ma'am, Mr. Anoop Kumar, other professors, my teachers on this panel, and most importantly to the prospective students and parents in attendance of this session, I wish you a very good morning. I've been invited to speak very briefly on my transformation from a student to a leader. Now, let me start by saying that the legal profession is such that one continues to be a student of law till one's last breath. So even today, I continue to remain a student of law. And in fact, as ma'am said, I remain a student of Symbiosis Law School since I'm currently pursuing my master's, which I decided to do while continuing my law practice. Now, coming to the leadership role, an important facet of leadership is being a contributor, maybe a contributor to society, to my clients, to my family, and of course to Symbiosis Law School. And it is Symbiosis Law School that has played an important and tremendous role in me being a contributor. And one thing for sure has happened is that my transformation. You must realize that any person is a mixture of varied contributors in that person's life. May it be parents, experiences, friends, family, spouse, and such. One very important and early contributing factor that shapes a person is the educational institution that a person is associated with. One of the primary reasons that Symbiosis Law School is highly ranked and highly sought after as an educational institution is not only because of the exceptional quality of academics, but also the immense opportunities that the institution provides in varied areas such as sports, drama, moot courts, as well as internships and placements. Symbiosis imparts education, which is a much wider term than simply academics. It imparts and teaches important values that you need as a person and as a professional. The law school therefore shapes you as a person in a complete and holistic manner. Some other important marks of a good institution are the qualities of adaptability, willingness to change, and being open to feedback. The pandemic and the lockdown took all of us by surprise, and things changed virtually overnight. Symbiosis Law School adapted to the situation and almost immediately converted its entire teaching mechanism and the admission process to an efficient online system with little or no disruption to the students. This also includes the library, which is an extremely difficult thing to convert online, but even the library has been converted completely online. Also, I know for a fact that almost on an annual basis, Symbiosis Law School tweaks its syllabus and its teaching methods to meet the requirement of the market and the change in laws. I'm happy to state that there are new subjects and new teaching techniques introduced over the years, which are a great improvement over what I was exposed to from the years 2004 to 2009 when I was a student. This not only shows that Symbiosis is student-centric, but this also shows the flexibility, adaptability, and willingness to meet market conditions, all important qualities that they also try to imbibe into their own students. Therefore, Symbiosis is one of the primary reasons for my transformation from a student to a contributor. It may also be noted that there are three important pillars to any great educational institution, namely its faculty, its students, and its alumni. The faculty, under the leadership and guidance of Dr. Gurpur ma'am, is one of the best amongst law schools. As for the students, it is your duty and responsibility to gain the maximum from the institution in terms of academics and other activities and make the most of the wide range of opportunities that are provided by Symbiosis. As for the alumni, I'm happy to state that we have an active and vibrant alumni network, which not only contributes back to Symbiosis, but also contributes to each other in terms of leads and career opportunities. This is the part of the collaborative approach that is an important value taught to us by Symbiosis Law School. Through the alumni network, I am today not only connected to almost all major corporate houses and law firms, but in fact, I have a home in almost every city in India. This would not have been possible without the true diversity of Symbiosis. And lastly, I must also add here that leaving aside everything else, being part of Symbiosis Law School is a lot of fun and enjoyment. I've had some of my best memories and my closest friends during my time at Symbiosis. A lot of you, sorry, I apologize. I think I got muted. A lot of you will be from out of Pune and probably from out of Maharashtra. I will vouch for the fact that Pune is a very welcoming and safe city. And once you clear the rigorous examination process, be ready for some excellent and life-changing experiences. And this is a journey worth experiencing. It is a privilege and honor for me to be associated with Symbiosis Law School in various capacities over the years. I once again thank the institution for giving me an opportunity and an excellent platform to jumpstart my career. With that, I conclude. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rahul. As we move to the more detailed ideas of academics in the SLS Pune, with my deputy director and a senior faculty member, a specialist in corporate law and a former faculty of ANUJS, Dr. Bindu Ronald. Before that, I would like to address some of the questions here. Somebody asked whether the date of the SLAT exam also will change. My answer is yes, CLAT is changing its date because the CBSE 12th standard exams are likely to be, I mean, they are already withheld and they are yet to announce another date. Because parents are always waiting for this anxiety to be over, we would see that we accommodate these changes and then we will announce if there is any change. Secondly, the current approach that we have in terms of changing the even center-based mode of testing due to the COVID crisis, that country is just coming out of, and in some places it is still in the peak, that we may have some changes to announce. We have already announced on the website for all of you to be ready for a home-based proctor test, like how your senior batch did. Now, rest of the questions I'll take up once this current student testimony gets over, which is a quick one minute shot. Okay, over to you.
My name is Akarsh Banyal, and I'm currently a student in the third year of the five-year BALLB program. My experience at Symbiosis Law School Pune has been nothing short of inspirational. From the first year itself, in addition to illustrious faculty members and a world-class library inculcating a spirit of academia within me, I was introduced to a wide array of both skill and value-based courses that were specifically geared towards the 21st century. Moreover, I have been able to cultivate my interests in the field of international law owing to the college's remarkable internationalization efforts and also extra and co-curricular opportunities such as moot court competitions, model UNs, and much more. In furtherance of the same, owing to SLS and Dr. Gurpur's constant guidance, I was also able to secure an internship under the United Nations Special Rapporteur for Trafficking in Persons, and shall also be assisting a sitting ad hoc judge at the International Tribunal for the Law of the Sea. Even during the pandemic, the college has been a constant pillar of strength for the entire student community through its active engagement and support initiatives. All things considered, SLS provides each student with the platform that allows one to discover, hone, and actualize their skills to indeed make a difference.
Hello everyone, my name is Ishita Soni and I am a penultimate year student at Symbiosis Law School Pune. My experience in college has been holistic and wholesome, to say the least. In terms of the academic opportunities, college not only has certain distinguished faculty members who even go an extra mile and assist us with our publications, research, articles and assignments after the college course, but we also get certain impeccable resource persons who are excellent in their own respective fields through workshops, guest lectures, and seminars. It allows us to gain that practical knowledge of every field outside the classroom. College also offers us with certain exceptional internship and research opportunities. And in addition to that, certain public speaking opportunities through Model United Nations, parliamentary debates, and moot court competitions. I, for myself, have represented the college in various national and international MOOCs. Even with respect to extra and co-curricular activities, in the first 2 years, participated in the opening dance ceremony and thereafter in the conclave. It allows students like me to pursue their passion along with their legal interests and hone their finer skills, which are necessary to build an all-round personality. With that, I believe that with the assistance of my faculty, my peers, and my seniors, who are always just a call away, I shall be able to pursue my career in litigation, which is what I aspire to do after college.
So we should thank those students. In the meanwhile, as Dr. Bindu is coming in to give the highlights of the academics, I would like to impress upon the parents that your questions on postponement of CLAT, proctored exam, etc., we can give definitive answer only in a week's time, because we don't want to decide dates before we know the dates of the CBSE exam and final dates for other entrance examinations. We don't want you to go through the clash of dates and inconvenience. Another question on VAT, and another question on what are the contents of the SLAT papers? Are old question papers available? We don't have a system of old question paper, but regarding the VAT and the preparation and the content of the examination, we are having a faculty coming in. Somebody was asking about the difference between the outcome of BALLB and BPALLB. There is no difference in the outcome. In terms of training, there is a difference, but you are given wide array of corporate related careers when you do BPALLB. Somebody asked, I don't have math and can I still do BBALLB? You can still do if you were a reasonably good student till your 10th. So over to Dr. Bindu.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I hope I'm audible to all. A very warm welcome and good morning to all the viewers who are watching this seminar live from different parts of the country, and I think also from different parts of the world. I'm Professor Dr. Bindu Ronald, and I'm a professor and deputy director academics at Symbiosis Law School, Pune. And I've been working at Symbiosis Law School, Pune since 2007. My association with the law school has been long, and I've always taken pride to say that I had joined Symbiosis Law School as a student more than three decades ago. And I was happy to choose this very cosmopolitan place to do my five-year law program then. And years later, after a great association of a couple of years with the National University of Juridical Science, Kolkata, where I was a faculty, to return to my alma mater, joining Symbiosis Law School as a faculty and to be on the other side of the table. Symbiosis Law School is definitely the flagship institution of Symbiosis International University and has been a leading law school of the country. You've already got a glimpse and overview of the law school when Dr. Gurpur was speaking to you. I'll provide you all with a glimpse of academics at Symbiosis Law School. I take pride in stating that academics at this law school has been very carefully nurtured, keeping in mind the national and global perspectives and also the market conditions and the requirements that are there. We offer BALLB honors and BBALLB honors, which is our flagship program, the three-year LLB program, and also the one-year LLM program with eight different specializations. We also offer diploma programs and various value-added certificate courses, which a student can undertake along with his or her degree program. We are a law school where we have a cutting-edge curriculum, which is prepared taking feedbacks from our stakeholders, which include our students, parents, academia, international experts, industry, bar, and bench, making it extremely rich, contemporary, and relevant. Teaching here is technology driven, so be it in curriculum delivery or in the reception by students, technology plays an extremely important role. In fact, during this COVID period, we have been online, ensuring that teaching learning does not suffer in any way. We have a technology driven teaching learning platform, and we have learning management systems and portal that is there, which allows us to register all details, be it uploading videos, be it uploading attendance, student progression, providing a platform to parents to see how their wards are progressing. LMS has been a technology that has been aiding Symbiosis Law School. We have a program structure where all the courses have defined objectives, identified learning outcomes, and all our courses, course outcomes, are mapped to the program outcomes. Our assessments are also mapped to the course outcomes, which are prepared for each course and circulated to the students along with a very, very detailed session plan in the beginning of the semester. The Bloom's taxonomy table of cognitive processes is followed in designing our courses and course objectives. Our program introduces students not only to law courses as per the Bar Council of India's requirement, but it also provides a glimpse of courses from other institutions which we offer under our floating credit program and under our inter-institute credit transfer programs. Our courses have experiential learning component to it, and our students are also part of various programs such as the legal aid activities, Lok Adalats, visits to various tribunals and courts regularly. We are the first law school in the country to introduce skill learning courses, which prepares and equips our students to be market ready. And we have a skill center and ADR center and various workshops and initiatives that are conducted for the benefit of our students. If we can shift the slide, please. We have an extremely robust student care and support system, and every student is important to us. We have developed a very result-oriented academic success program, which helps weak students to cope with the courses where they are weak and feel the need for additional support. We have a very strong mentor-mentee system, and each student is assigned a faculty mentor within a week of joining the law school. And also, we provide senior students as buddies to handhold our new batch of students as they enter the portals of the law school and continue their journey with us. Our crisis management team ensures that students have a very good support in case of any emergencies or exigencies that they may face while they stay away from home. We are extremely sensitive to the mental health support that some of our students may require, and we provide students with counseling sessions from time to time on need basis. Our placement training and entrepreneurship cell provides the necessary training and support requirement to the students for their internship and placement. And we always say that although Symbiosis is not a guarantee to placement, we train our students well, and placement is always a culmination of what the student does through his or her time at the law school. Our teaching process also includes the most innovative practices, and our courses incorporate ethics and skills. We teach our student teams, we teach our students team building, and we also have team teaching where a course is co-taught by more than one faculty. Going to the next slide on teaching and learning, we adopt a student-centric learning and teaching pedagogy, and our teaching pedagogy includes seminars, presentations, group discussions, case studies, MOOCs, movies, documentary analysis, etc. Our teaching pedagogy includes lectures in the classroom, but we also supplement lectures with various flipped learning methodology of teaching. We use stimulation exercises as a method of teaching. Like, for example, our students studying company law learn board management by a boardroom stimulation exercise. One exercise which takes them through the chapter on directors, accounts, meetings, and even mergers and acquisitions and winding up and procedural aspects. An exercise where research is required and makes the students dive deep to emerge with pearls of wisdom and knowledge. We respond to a diverse learning needs that are there of our students and train them in essential lawyering skills as mooting, trial advocacy, MUNs, debates, and also provide leadership training through our student cell initiatives. If I may ask for the next slide on learning beyond the classrooms, we don't believe only in classroom teaching, and our students go beyond classrooms where we teach the students. We organize public lecture series such as the Y.V. Chandrachud Memorial Lecture. This time for the Y.V. Chandrachud Memorial Lecture, we had none other than the Nobel Peace Laureate Sri Kailash Satyarthi, people from whose lives we learn so much, people whose lives are in themselves an ocean of wealth of learning and which we can emulate. We also have late V.G. Deshmukh Memorial Lecture, which we organize in association with the Public Trust Governance. The next slide, please. In 2020, we had the privilege of listening to our former Defense Secretary, Sri Shekhar Dutt, a retired IAS officer. The next slide. We invite a large number of legal luminaries and experts ensure that a learning is provided to the students, ensuring that a learning enrichment where students gain from
experience and expertise of our resource persons. This year, we introduced our students to a number of international guests. We had the international judge lecture series, international experts, where they delivered a large number of lectures. And we brought international and national experience to our classroom. The next slide. The teaching learning is supported by a very rich learning resource center, which has IT resource and supports and support and services provided to the students with a very rich e-learning resource center where our students can access material even remotely sitting anywhere in the world. We have a whopping investment of over a crore of rupees per annum on our learning resource management. With a very strong IT policy, with 24 hours Wi-Fi service, with IT support for teaching learning, Symbiosis Law School surely stands above other law schools. The journey with Symbiosis Law School Pune is very enriching and satisfying, and I invite you to join Symbiosis Law School Pune and help us prepare you for a very bright future. Thank you, and I now invite Professor Kshitij Naik there to take the audience through the other initiatives at Symbiosis Law School. Over to you, ma'am, and Professor Kshitij.
Yeah, Kshitij, as you come in, I would like to answer one or two questions. Many of them are asking about writing ability test, just hold on. And then it is also that about postponement and other things. Let us just take a stock of things. As I told you already, be patient because we have to tally the different dates. And we have to look at first if the CBSE is going to announce its dates. Without that, if we now postpone or change the exam date suddenly, without much deliberation, we will have to change again. Because you all trust us, you look at our discipline and credibility, we will have to be very careful and responsible in announcing these dates. The questions on whether a compartment student is accepted, no. We urge the compartment students to wait to complete their compartment and then come back next year applying for it. NIOS board is accepted if the 10th is done in a normal way. If 12th is NIOS and 10th is a normal 10th in the direct mode, then it is acceptable. Both being NIOS is not accepted. Either of them have to be in the direct mode, because Bar Council has clearly told us in a couple of queries that we had in the past that there has to be some formal mode of education in terms of competency and other things. Now, I was not getting this. What is this media rumor somebody is talking about? I will deliberate on that. Somebody was asking about whether management quota seat is there. We don't have a quota called management. Please never use that term because we have completely closed that. There was a time when discretionary 15% was given and we were using that discretionary quota, of course, with the particular reference to the 10th score, 12th score and the SLAT score. But now that has been ended because for our 15% seats, we get about 4,000 applications and it becomes impossible and we don't want to compromise merit because those students will be sitting with the, as I told you, the creamy layer of India in terms of intelligentsia. So that question also I'm going to answer in the negative. Now we'll continue once our esteemed colleagues present further. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am, for clarifying these doubts. It's because these are the exact questions that we get even on our telephone numbers and even in through mail, because people kind of tend to believe in what is being spread around in the media. And I would again, you know, I reiterating what you said, would like them to only check the official college website, the Symbiosis Law School website, simlaw.ac.in, for regular updates and not any other supposedly official websites that are there who will kind of give you, or even private players who kind of work as mediators or middlemen in the admission process. Please do not trust them. We do not encourage those kind of practices. Thank you very much, ma'am. I will move on and I'll present the next few points with respect to SLS Pune. As mentioned over here, we have an institutionalized moot court and mock trial activities, which are one of our USPs and one of the highlights of our time at SLS Pune. As also showed by ma'am in one of her previous slides, we recently concluded with our criminal trial advocacy competition, which is one of our highlights of the year, one of the most keenly awaited events of the year, which is attended by teams from some of the most prominent colleges nationally as well as internationally. We have teams coming from Europe, all over the world for these competitions, thus making mooting an extremely rigorous and one of the most important activities on which we focus here at SLS Pune. As mentioned over here, we have a Law Hawks Forum, which conducts several academic activities beyond law to kind of build the personality of the students for when they enter the industry, when they entered the job scenario, they kind of are completely prepared. We have a very strong debate society, and I'm kind of very proud and happy to kind of note over here that it has gone from strength to strength over the years, with some of our debaters actually competing and winning the best debating tournaments in the world, and not just kind of representing but also winning individual accolades as well as group accolades for the institutes, thus kind of improving their credentials. So when these same students apply for their LLM admissions or when they are applying to Ivy League colleges, these achievements or their CV when they participate in these debate competitions through college work to their advantage in securing this position. We also have a it's not mentioned over here, but through the international cell, we also have a very efficient Model United Nations Society. I remember when I was interacting with the first year students when they took admission, a lot of them actually came from an MUN background, where they used to conduct MUNs in the so can you just go back to the previous slide? So they used to participate in this mock United Nations, Model United Nations competition in their school. So I'm kind of very happy to denote over here that we also kind of encourage these activities where people participate in national as well as international MUN. Okay, there was an interruption in between. So through this Model United Nations, recently we concluded with our flagship event where we invited guests and from the Latin American countries as well, and we have cross-continental kind of participation, thus exposing the students to not just the local, domestic, national kind of interactions, but also to international cultures, as well as when they're interacting with people from different kind of spheres of the society, that helps them enrich their personality when they're moving ahead in that. We are also winners in several prestigious debate competitions. Later on, we'll be presenting a small list in front of you. However, you might find the details of the same also on our website. And if you even individually contact us later for more details on the same, we will be in a position to kind of help you with this. Now I would like Dr. Dhanaji Jadhav sir to kind of take over the next points and elucidate upon the key highlights and the USPs of SLS Pune.
Previous slide, please.
Now, before Dr. Jadhav takes over, I want to be very direct, directly responding to this question that SLS Pune does not prefer Pune students. You know, we select very blindly. We have more than 20,000 applicants for the entrance exam, and we have to select 300 out of them. Whether a student is in Mumbai or Pune or Delhi is secondary. Whether that student is making it to the top rank is primary. So several surprises exist. You would be surprised to see. I have taken over in 2007. I did the data analytics. Still about we opened campuses in Noida, Hyderabad, and Nagpur in 2010 to 2019. We used to get about 60 to 70% applicants coming from North and Central region. Today, we get large percentage of selected students coming from Mumbai, Bangalore, and also from Pune. Some of them shift to Pune just after this child gets the admission. Therefore, who is Pune and who is not Pune is the secondary. It is mainly who makes it to this examination. Therefore, these rumors, these negative thoughts, please don't harbor. Work hard. See how you will crack this examination and make it to the top 2,000 students who are selected, because your entrance exam score is given 50% weightage. So normally for BA group, we have more applications. BBA LLB group, we have slightly less applications. However, when it comes to scoring, we have in BA group, the cutoff is BA LLB honors group. The cutoff is coming anywhere between 102 to 110 out of 150. Whereas for BBA group, it can come anywhere between 100 to 115. So it varies every year. I think I have answered your question. Now over to Dr. Sahib.
Thank you, madam.
Good morning, one and all. When we characterize as an institution, as an institution of an excellence, what are those contributing factors which make Symbiosis Law School Pune as one of the center of an excellence? More particularly, while putting the student at a center point, there are many other factors where the Symbiosis from inceptions look into overall holistic development of the student. In addition to the professional skill development, as well as the development in terms of an academics, we are also emphasizing on development of the student on many aspects of personal level. And as an effect of it, we have able to produce many alumni, those who are there in the judiciary, those who are there in the emerging corporate sector, those who are there in many aspects of professions of our society. When we are talking about the entire contribution of Symbiosis, which rank consistently among the top law school in the country, more particularly because we are exercising various efforts, more particularly the contribution of the student, where the students do submit their research paper under the able guidance of their teachers. And probably as the outcome of it, more than 500 papers are published into various reputed journals of national and international repute and many index journals. But in addition to that, the students have bought laurels for the institutions, and many feathers have been added in the cap because of strenuous efforts and achievement of the student. More particularly, to develop such a professional dynamism, we are emphasizing on participation of a student into various competitions, may it be a debate competition, may it be a moot court competitions, may it be even the competitions which develops their skill of profession of advocacy. So this overall development altogether help us to achieve the end result, so that make this student job ready as well as the professional ready. And when we are talking about the student achievement, it in recent past, whatsoever the noteworthy contribution of the student is there, more particularly because of their wide participation in co-curricular and curricular activities, that speaks the volumes about the contribution of institution for the student. Overall growth of the student, if you see, more particularly right from beginning, we are employing many techniques in terms of an academics, in terms of a profession, more particularly for learning skill, experiential learning, diversified clinical pedagogies of exposing to the students to the practical knowledge of law, because most of the times what happens when the students entered into the courtroom, he tried to learn the laws. But because of our pedagogies of teaching, students try to learn because of that exposure to the practical learning skills. And that altogether can be characterized as one of the few attributes of the Symbiosis institution, which makes the Symbiosis as an institution of difference. For rest of the slide and its information, I request Professor Kshitij to explain.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. We don't have a lot of time, so I'll quickly rush through this achievements, as I don't really have to read these achievements out. As you can see from the slide over here, and these are only achievements from 2020. So during the pandemic, when the whole world was actually suffering, as you can see, some of our students have actually won laurels for our nation, laurels for our college and for the university by not just participating, but also winning some of these international national tournaments. And yeah, I would like to kind of denote over here that in all these tournaments and moots and the debate competitions that they participate, the college supports them in every way. So not just in terms of giving approvals, but in terms of finances, in terms of reimbursement, in terms of so many other things, the college kind of supports the students. So next slide, sir. These are some of the snapshots from our student development activities, whether it is the debates, the moots. Next slide. There's one more testimony from our student.
before you play the testimony.
This video finds you and your loved ones.
Can you pause the video, please?
Harish Bakshi, and I'm a fourth year.
Yes.
It's okay. Let's proceed. I'll talk after that. Yeah.
A student currently in the eighth semester of Symbiosis Law School, Pune. Speaking about my professional discourse, I'm slated to join Linklaters London, which is a magic circle firm situated in London in the year 2023, something that I'm really excited about because it would help me imbibe the professional values that Symbiosis Law School Pune has instilled in me. Talking about my 4 years here in college, the experience has been really incredible to say the least. And this is only because of two reasons. The amazing peer support that Symbiosis Law School Pune provides, as well as the brilliant academic endeavors that the college dictates. The academic culture is competitive and enriching. But to add on to that, there are numerous endeavors that have been undertaken by college to make our learnings more holistic. Just to give an example, the numerous guest lectures that are conducted by college along with the skill workshops not only give us a practical insight, but also give us a sneak peek into the professional legal world. To add on to that, we have various extra and co-curricular activities in the college, such as mooting, debating, dancing, student advisory board, and various extracurricular and co-curricular clubs. This adds on to the holistic development of an individual. To the people who are sitting and watching this amidst these unprecedented times, I would just like to say one thing, that despite everything, if you choose to join Symbiosis Law School Pune, then this would be one of the best decisions of your life, as the brilliant academic culture and the peer support that you would get in terms of not only the intra-peer support, but also the alumni support is unmatched to any other place that we have interacted or heard of. Take care, and we hope to see you soon in college.
We brought Tarish Paksh to you for one reason. Tarish Bakshi comes from a very remote area in Himachal, and out of sheer hard work and getting the using the breaks that he got for internship to make the right connections, today he has made it into the magic circle firm. So somebody was asking me the question, do you provide exposure to international law firm internships and jobs? So this is an evidence for you. Thank you. Let's go to the next information, please, which is about how we develop the students for placements, which is an important question which was asked quickly.
More particularly, if you see, the gone are those days where the scope of law and legal profession is limited to the litigations or litigation practice. There are varieties of opportunities and avenues which are available to the student of law. And considering this diversifications of legal profession, Symbiosis Law School Pune is emphasizing on various aspects of professions because of complexities of the corporate arena, many more opportunities are available to the student law graduates after completion of their graduations. So our emphasis is there in respect of or in furtherance to the overall development of the students, basically on the induction program, career counseling or the mentoring sessions, which sharpen their ideas and views in respect of their choices of profession. We also organize career path identification and orientation program through various experts from the industries, corporate sectors, and professions. This usually helps the student for selecting an apt choice of their career. Whereas as a part of career selections, there are many other attributes which are rather can be considered as a part and parcel of their skill. And so as to sharpen their skills, so as to develop their skills, we are emphasizing on resume writing workshop, training in diverse career, as well as developing curriculum vitae, as well as the course on leadership building program, as well as many soft skills and the skills which are related to the corporate sector or the skills which are related to the professions, so that ultimately which will able to produce a fruitful results so as to enhance the employabilities of our law graduates, either in corporate sector, legal professions, even banking sector, or diversified areas of choices of their profession. Thank you. I request Professor Santosh Agao to continue with the next slide.
Yeah, Yeah. So good afternoon, everyone. Now we have a student advisory board, which is generally called as student council, whereby and various representation by the students of all across all divisions, disciplines like 5-year, 3-year, and LLM. Students are involved and engaged as a part, and they also volunteer and play a very important role as a representation from the students with the management and college authority, university authorities. Students volunteer to work under various committees and cells under student advisory board, whereby various ideas are floated from the students, and the exposure is given to the students to exchange the ideas, innovate new experiment, and innovate the new programs, new events, and new culture, which accordingly gives a chance to students to exchange with all those ideas. So we have academic research committee, alumni committee, regulatory committee, extra and co-curricular committee, program and event management, peer and student welfare committee. Apart from this, we have various departmental cells, as you can see in the slide, which helps the students to learn the managerial behavior, managerial communications, teamwork, problem solving behavior, as well as experimentation, innovation, and a tradition of being together. And that accordingly helps the students in future and even during their studentship. Next slide, please. The Student Advisory Board, along with this separate annual FEST committee or SIMBO committee, host various events. This time, even during COVID, we had the biggest virtual online annual FEST, during which more than 50 various events, literary to co-curricular to extracurricular, various events, which were hosted by the student, by the college, and the students have developed a lot of platform by which Honorable Pro Chancellor Dr. Vidya Rodhikar Ma'am, Dr. Rajni Gupta, Pro Vice Chancellor, our Dean Ma'am, Dr. Gupta Ma'am, and the chief guest, Mr. Suresh Prabhu, who have inaugurated and opened the SIMBO 2021 online virtual fest. More than this, we had more than 50 events, 22 committees, and where participation more than four and viewers more than 4,500 at the time of this 4 days event. We had also Model United Nations as an international competition, and we have participation in the symbol. Next slide, please. Where we had participation from the local to national to international universities, institutions, and colleges during this entire event, and whereby the students have learned how the problems do not stop them, and still the motivation can be alive, and they can participate, contribute, and learn by the content. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So one of the special highlights of the SIMBO was that amongst many events was the law theater, which my colleague Dr. Sujata Arya will be speaking further. That where law theater is an idea by our honorable chancellor, Sir Dr. S. B. Muzumdar, sir, by which the legal evidence is created by a drama, by which the this time we had a theme of law theater on pandemic situation and legal issues, and that was being covered. You can check on in the incoming days on social media. We have various field visits, so the learning do not stop in the classroom. It is extended and outreach by various outreach programs and various programs outside the classroom by organizing various field visits to government offices, NGOs, and various stakeholders who are interlinked to the topic to give a better understanding of the knowledge, law and practice and policy. The exposure is given to the students, and by which students learn before visit, during visit, and post visit to understand the overall experience of the law. Now I invite Dr. Dhanaji sir to speak about the further the practices in the light of internships and externships and the career advancement, whereby we have entrepreneurships and incubator department as career professional development cell, whereby we facilitate their various additional skills, and we groom them in the light of advanced skills which are required in the market. So over to Dhanaji sir.
Thank you, Dr. Santosh. Next slide, please. As a moment back, I was referring about the novelty of the legal professions. And during the recent past, this legal professions, which is termed to be a noble profession of the society, it has undergone into a tremendous change. And when the opportunities are available with the corporate sectors. We have very strong track record of our placement, and we do have a very strong collaborations with the many industry partners, corporate partners. What particularly when we are thinking about what are those value-added programs the institution is running, International Technology and IP Moot Court Competitions. This is one of the innovative features of Symbiosis Law School, Pune. There are many workshops which are persistently organized on various emerging areas of skills. And this probably the reasons that which keep the institutions, faculty members and student exposed to the emerging technology, cutting edge technology, and keep themselves to be updated with the technology in law. There are many capsule courses which we are running. In addition to that, one another academic piece for the student is the guest lecture series, wherein we are inviting to many legal luminaries from the professions, from the bar, from the bench, and from the academics, which surely help for their academic boosting. There are many programs which are also there, more particularly on drafting, then judgment writing. This surely helps for those students who are interested more particularly to make their career in judiciary or judicial services. There are certain industry programs, industry training programs, which are prepared, which are specially mean for expose the students to the industry requirement. There are civil service exam orientation programs. This is on the basis of the demands of the students, because a few of the students, those who intend to make their career into civil services where on the basis of their law as basic qualifications, it surely helps to such a students, those who are aspirants for the civil services. So far as our track record and our bond with the many corporate partners, it includes Surana and Surana, Krishna and Saurashtra, banks like the debt recovery tribunals, DSK Legal, then PUC, then ICICI, National Bar Association of India, Tata Technology, Maharashtra Judicial Academy, Cyril Amarchand and Mangal Das, and one all reputed firms in the country where our students are recruited. If we see overall placement of the student, more particularly in law firms, many of our students are recruited, then percentage quotes sizably more than 59%, and as well as 28 in the companies, even banking sector, a lot many opportunities are available. So 8% of our law graduates, they are recruited over there, and 3% in many government sectors, as well as 2% in NGO. And this track record, that speaks about the credibility and potential of Symbiosis Law School Pune. And that is probably the reason that which makes Symbiosis Law School Pune as an institution of excellence. Next slide, please. We also offer the scholarship from Symbiosis International Deemed University, which offer the scholarship. And if you see the record, previous record, ultimately, in academic year 2020-21, for undergraduate and postgraduate students, more than 8 crore of rupees scholarship was granted to the student in furtherance to the academic interests. Yes, the alumni speaks about the credibility and potential of the institutions. If you see all together, this is not just a past record. Because the alumni record of the alumni, it's not speaks about the credibility of the institutions, but it also shoulders an accountability on the institutions, because those future prospectors, the students, those who sought the admissions or intend to seek an admissions, they look forward it as their imaginary career options. And more particularly, if you see, there are 3 high court sitting judges of Bombay High Court, as well as more than 31 lower court judges. We have our student in leading law firms of our country. Our students are there in business, art, and social entrepreneurship, and they're also there in content writers and journalism, as well as editors in many law journals. They are in-house counsel, general managers of the national and international companies. They're working as attorneys and solicitors abroad in India, as well as they are working in many fields that makes the proud for the institutions. Our students are recruited to the top law firms. They're working as law clerks with the Supreme Court and High Courts. They are working in CAM, NDA, GSA, L&T division, Indian Law Services, Administrative Services, Personal and HR Specialist, many law offices, law as many are working as a law officers in CBI. They are working in different leadership qualities. They are working in different leadership positions. They are working as a researcher as well as academicians too. Next slide, please. So as to maintain this track record and to maintain the quality, this is just not a feature of Symbiosis Law School Pune. This meticulous planning of teaching and imparting quality of legal education is minutely observed, and it is implemented in a letter and spirit, more particularly the meticulous academic calendar planning, the session plans, and its revisions, more so as to make it in tune with the changing facet of law, feedback sessions to maintain the transparency, then midterm review as well as interim review, which also facilitate the academic sincerity as well as transparency in the system. The student feedback system is altogether make this process more democratic, where students get an opportunity to participate in academic decision making. The open house system is altogether something like where the teachers work as a parent teachers, and this surely helps to the students to understand their emotional imbalances in the circumstances when they are, yes, of course, the Pune is such a destination and a beautiful city, but those who are the hostelites, this open house system, which surely helps them to come out from any kind of emotional imbalance. For the rest of the things, I request my colleague, Professor Dr. Sujata, to explain the same. Dr. Sujata.
So a very good afternoon and a warm welcome to the students and prospective parents. Good afternoon, Dr. Gurpur, ma'am, and other colleagues.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. So we'll just have a quick glimpse. We've already spoken about internationalization at SLS Pune. We do have collaborations across the globe, and this results in a lot of opportunities for students as well as the faculty members. We have membership in very prestigious institutions like GAGE, IALS, ASLI, IUCN. And from them, we have a lot of experts who come and join us for joint projects or research, providing opportunities again, both for faculty as well as for students, and experts who come and guide our students, engage lectures. Symbiosis Law School has been the proud recipient of 4 prestigious Erasmus Plus CBHE projects, as well as the DAD project, which is given by the German government. And this has again provided opportunities for faculty as well as students. For the students, right from the first year, we do offer the certificate program in European Union Legal Studies. It's been nearly a decade of success that we have been launching this certificate program. And we also offer the Asian Legal Studies. This year, we will also offer the certificate program to right from the first year onwards. As an outcome of our Erasmus projects, we have introduced 28 new EU studies related courses. We also have introduced value added certificate courses and a specialized LLM program. Our faculty have gone under various exchange programs through the Fulbright scholarship or through the EU project. We do have Gyan scholars coming in. And at the, in the campus of Symbiosis Law School Pune, it's never been that we've never had scholar in residence or some international faculty who are interacting with the students, providing them expert guidance. And this year, because of the COVID, we've had a virtual treat of academicians who have been interacting with both us as well as students. 60% of our faculty have had exposure abroad, and this resulting in a lot of comparative aspects which are being brought into the teaching and learning into the law curricula. For the first year specifically, we conduct an exclusive clinical writing course, which is done by a US faculty. This is an intensive 1-month program which happens. And we have 3 courses which jointly conduct this. You have contract research as well as thoughts. So from the first year, students are given the experience of a moot court experience, and this is one of the best practice brought by our director, madam, because the US faculties are very well trained in legal writing and legal skills. So we also undertake a lot of joint research and teaching engagement. Again, the students also join the faculty in this, whether it's in journal editing or in other court authoring, etc. We have, and I did see a question on the chat box, a lot of opportunities for both student exchange, for semester exchange, summer school programs. And now because of the COVID, many of our students are getting the opportunity of semester exchange the summer schools on an online mode. Already Professor Shitaj has emphasized about the importance of the MUN, the parliamentary debates and other mock trials, as well as Dr. Santosh Agarwal has spoken about the law theater. These are all combined with our teaching and learning. They form a part of the assessment. And many of our students have got internships, whether in New York or in the International Criminal Court in Rwanda and in other places across the globe. Because of the rich teaching and learning that we have at SLS, students have had an opportunity of getting employment in Singapore, Dubai, LLM admissions in prestigious universities like Cornell, Georgetown, Cambridge, Oxford, Leiden, and the number is keeping on increasing. So every year, the number of LORs that we are providing and the opportunities that our students are getting to do their LLM is really impressive. Next slide, please. So just to give you a glimpse, even for our orientation, we did have professors like Tonya Kowalski, we had Professor Mimi Samuel, Dr. Louise Francesi, all senior experts who guided our students about how to choose their career path, how to achieve their goals. And under the ILS Distinguished Speaker Program, we've had both former as well as current judges who addressed our students on different themes. So you can see some of the glimpses here. We've had Justice Richard Goldstone, we've had Judge Francesca Piercini, who's a current judge of the Supreme Court of India. We've had Justice Emmanuel, former president of East African Court of Justice, talking about environmental law and its principles. And we've had John Justice Hedigan talking about career, his career and his reflections in law. Next slide, please. So apart from that, we've had the Eurasia Distinguished Speaker Program and our emphasis on the EU courses. And we've had experts right from Poland, from Sofia University, Bulgaria, from UK, again addressing our students on different themes. Yes, next slide, please. So this is a continuation, some of the glimpses of our students getting exposed to a whole range of different topics and a range of ideas. Next slide. And I've already mentioned this, but this is a glimpse of the moot court orientation which happened for the first year students this year, happened from 4th to the 16th of December. And in spite of the COVID, we continued with our best practice with the judge taking our students through the mooting exercise, what is IRAC, and a virtual moot assessment, which also took place. So we've also had the SLS Distinguished Speaker Program, wherein we've had faculties talking about constitution and administrative law. We've had Professor Michael Blasey, again, talking about class actions. In the US, this was also for the first year students, again providing a different comparative aspect. Next slide, please. And these are again, we have many more to show, but these are just the glimpses of the many student exchanges that we provide to our students because of the number of collaborations that we have. And we are one of the institute, in spite of being a law institute, that we are able to convert the credits that the students get into the internal marks, and you know, we make all the efforts so that students get an opportunity to at least have one kind of an exposure throughout their 5 years at the law school. So these are another glimpses of the semester exchange that our students have got the opportunity. And I've just mentioned, and so has Dr. Gurpal ma'am and our other colleagues, that our faculty are well trained So we've had the Eurasia training where the faculties have gone to Italy, Bulgaria, as well as Poland. Next slide. Next slide. And we are working on currently on these four projects. So this is the glimpse of the 21st century teaching skills. And so the emphasis that we are bringing about ICT training and 21st teaching skills into the teaching pedagogy at SLS because of the vast kind of experience that the faculty members get through these training programs. So we are working currently on another very contemporary topic, which is climate change policy and law, and again glimpses that of the meetings that are right now going on. And so this is the last slide, which we've already talked about, but you can see that in spite of the pandemic, we had a very successful MUN which took place, which is aligned to our academic and co-curriculum. So every activity that we ensure is aligned with our teaching pedagogy. So thank you very much and welcome to Symbiosis Law School Pune. I now hand over to my colleague, Dr. Rupal Rao Desai.
Thank you, Professor Sujata, and hello, everyone. I'll quickly just take very briefly 2 minutes just to introduce to you about the research avenues that we have at Symbiosis Law School Pune. As you can see up on the screen, we have the Symbiosis Center for Advanced Legal Studies and Research. Though it mainly caters to the LLM and PhD program, but also it is responsible to provide various opportunities to the undergrad students to participate in various research projects, including the international projects that we have currently and which all the other faculty members have already mentioned to you. I'm not going to repeat the same. Now, besides this, you have a lot of opportunities to participate in conferences, seminars. We have an annual conference that we host every year. It has moved strength to strength from being a national and a law-based to international and interdisciplinary conference. So we have various specialization centers under that and various excellence centers under that. And currently we have aligned our excellence centers with the current running international projects, which are on migration law, climate change. We have an ongoing research on the online cybersecurity and various latest technologies like artificial intelligence, blockchain technology, also Internet of Things, which gives you a wholesome experience in terms of what is happening latest. All our students are very much motivated and encouraged to participate in all these different conferences. They have won awards also in various conferences and seminars. They get a hand-holding, a large support from the faculty members here because we also encourage students to co-author along with faculty members to ensure that their publications are also happening in various international and indexed, highly indexed journals like International Arbitration, where Akarsh, one of our students whom you heard earlier, has published along with our director, Dr. Shashikala Gurpur. And then you have various other opportunities. So given these research opportunities, I'm sure you're going to be able to make maximum out of it. We also have our courses aligned because you have right in the first year, the legal research methodology program and the 1 month mooting program along from US attorneys coming and training you in. So there is great quality research output. There are publications happening through our students. They are winning various awards in research. So this is just a glimpse of how our center motivates the students and helps them to go strength to strength in terms of their research as well. Now moving on, can we move to the next slide, please? So here you can also get a glimpse of how research is not looked at only very as a separate aspect, but we are integrating the research with the clinical experience of students, where students can go to the community, carry out community-based outreach programs, extension programs, help the community in paralegal aid services, paralegal services, and also our students are winning several competitions in these social legal avenues that they have. So also participation in Lok Adalat, and you can see over here, this is one of the other drives that our students conducted in terms of during the COVID times. We have also maintained our consultation programs with the collaborators like Yerwada Central Jail. We are having our students help the under trial prisoners during the COVID times. Also, this kind of dry ration drive for various people. Can we move to the next slide? We also have several collaborations with NGOs to provide social legal help. This is just a glimpse of our faculty research. Moving on, can we go to the next slide, please? And this is a glimpse of the student research, and you can see how the publications of the students have increased over the number of years. And yes, over to Abhijit Vasmatkar, sir, please. Yeah.
Thank you, Tavrin, and thank you, everyone. Thank you, ma'am. A very good afternoon to one and all. I may say good noon to everyone now. Good afternoon, good noon, Gurupur ma'am and other panel members. I would like to know the introduce about the admission process. In detail, the admission process is available on our website. Our telephone lines are another on. Our email, we are also another available to you to solve your another queries through our another email. We have already started with our registration process. The registration process is on. The payment closure date, the registration will close on 7th July 2021. So if you have not registered another yet, I urge you to register at the earliest. After what we another call it as a registration, we will be going for a slot, and after another slot, there will be a shortlisting in another process. As Gurupur ma'am has another already mentioned, that there will be around 20,000, will be touching a mark of 20,000 registrations, and those students will be appearing for set. So by putting a cutoff, we'll be shortlisting another candidates, and the shortlisting will another come out on 13th July 2021. Immediately, what you need to do is, if you are shortlisted, then you need to book your slot. And we are another providing you one day's window, that is 24 hours another window for you to book a slot. If you fail to book your slot, what we will do is, we'll give you another slot to our another convenience and wherever it is another available. And accordingly, there will be personal interaction with our another panel members, which will happen between 16th of July to 26th of July. You don't need to another come for PI, because one of the question was that, sir, do we need to come to another Pune to attend personal interaction? No, you don't need to come to another Pune. Through a virtual another mode, we would be conducting personal interactions with you. We will be having a panel of experts, and they will be engaging the personal interaction, the round of personal interaction.
Abhijit, you will have to clarify.
Yes, ma'am.
That this is about applying to the college. Without application to the college, even if they appear for the SLAT exam and have a good score, they will not be shortlisted for the college. So when does the SLAT application end? And when does the college application end is connected?
Ma'am, it is closing on, it is another closing on 7th July, madam. So I request the students to register for both SLAT first and then to register for institution. By making a payment to both another programs.
So if here you will have to clarify
both another programs, that is BLLB and VBLLB.
Shortlisting, yes, of candidates. The shortlisting is for what? Because this is what they have to know very clearly. So please clarify.
Ma'am, it will ma'am, it will another come in mind the next slide, ma'am. Give it 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So moving on to the next slide, wherein we have another put in the selection process little elaborately. As it has already been told, that there will be a computer-based SLAT examination. There will be different centers. You will have to choose your center. There the computer and the system will be put in place. you can appear for the examination. You can give this and appear for this LAT examination through this computer-based test, which is known as CBT in the mode. Now, the format of another CBT is there will be another 75 another questions for 1 mark another each, where logical reasoning, the questions would be another based coming from another area, that is logical reasoning, legal reasoning, analytical reasoning, reading comprehension, general knowledge, and few other another allied areas, which will be followed by writing ability test, which is there for 20 marks. So 75 another marks for objective type of another questions plus VAT. And both these examinations will be happening at the same, meaning one after another, immediately one after the other. Now here, the total duration for SLAT plus the writing ability test, which we call it as VAT, is 105 another minutes. And you need to clear this another particular test. And once you are another clear with this in a way, or appear for this another test, a score will another appear. On the basis of this another score, SLS Pune will be declaring our cutoff. So the shortlisting in the date. Shortlisting date.
Okay.
Can we mute all? Okay, thank you.
So our organizers will have to be a little more alert in muting all till they ask permission for opening, till the presentation is over, please. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you.
So after the SLAT is not over, on the basis of another SLAT, there will be a cutoff decided by the institution. And on the basis of that, shortlisting will be announced. And those another candidates who are shortlisted, only those candidates who are shortlisted will be called for personal interaction round. And for that purposes, as Gurpur ma'am has rightly pointed out, you will have to register not only for SET, but you have to register for individually for SLS Pune, Symbiosis Law School Pune, and you will have to pay also for SLS another Pune. If you are interested to appear for one program, then pay for one program. If you are interested to appear for both another programs, then you can pay for another both another programs. Then in personal another interaction, which constitutes around 30% of the overall another, which is for another 30 another marks, wherein the interaction will another happen, and here each students will roughly another get 8 to 10 minutes to interact with the panel members. Here, what we will judge is your academic another achievements, co-curricular another achievements, additional qualifications. If at all you have some awards, recognitions, then extracurricular activities. If you have another engaged in communication another skills, general poise another personality, etc. Now here, when we are talking about declaration of another merit list. Here, I request another every one of you to concentrate, because for declaration of another merit list, we take different components from these three parts. One, SLAT, objective another type of another questions, then writing ability test and personal interaction. So 50% of the weightage comes from the SLAT. Then 30% comes from the personal interaction and 20% comes from writing ability test. And combinedly, we will be publishing our another merit list. Most probably in first merit list, our all seats another would get exhausted. If required, we will put up second another merit list. And once first and second merit list are another out, we will be tentatively starting our another college on in the second week of August. So over to you, Gurpur ma'am, to continue with other slides. Thank you.
Yeah, these slides are, dear parents, thank you, Professor Abhijit. Dear parents, these slides are just indications of how our LLM PhD student Chaitra got the Cambridge Fellowship. Our another 5-year law course product got full scholarship in Oxford. The college supported her aside from introducing the professors and providing reference letter. Let's go to the next one. What we mean to say is our students are trained in such a way that they fit anywhere in the world. And this is revealed by some of the luminaries who have visited our institute. And our own past president of student association, he got admission to Cornell's LLM. Let's go to the next slide. This is about another set of alumni who are in the public service. It was already highlighted. They are engaging in the college and training our current students for civil service. Justice Revati Mohita Dere is also a parent of the institute. And they come, Sampath is our alumni convener. They come and support our students. You know, when you invest in a good college, you are not only investing in good faculty, learning process and resources and infrastructure and peer experience, you are going to be the beneficiary of this huge human capital, which has been built over the years. Some of these are leading leaders in their own avenues who can train your wards as interns and then for job. Now, employer testimony, you know, Dr. Bedi gave this testimony to the student when he was in second year. And today that student is a genius student who drafts our international law moot problem equal to anybody in the field from across the world. You know, that is the kind of hard work if student puts in. He was the one who came from a very challenging, financially challenging background, and today he is able to be the backbone of his family, and we helped him resettle as well. Let's go ahead. It was purely the alumni support. So this is where we see our future plan to be. We want to emerge as one of the top five in Asia, which is already we are recognized. We have collaborative programs with the various Asian and European and American universities. Our final year students, like the Jindal has done, are going to have a kind of 1 year short track JD program if they come in the merit and if they have the capacity and they apply. So we are finalizing our modalities with the 8 different United States law schools to qualify our students simultaneously as a JD student of first year, and then in 2 years they'll get the JD degree from US. And it may qualify them if they pass the local bar exam to practice in the US as well. So this kind of transnational qualification and professional expansion is in our cards. Within next 3 years, we will develop particular research centers, aside from what Dr. Rupal told, based on the current projects and grants we have. And we want to establish endowment-based chairs, etc. Now, let me quickly answer your questions. I think we'll play the video after I answer all the questions. There was one question whether this webinar recording will be available. Yes, it is available. We will send you the YouTube link to all those who have registered for this. I would request my IT team and admission advisors to do that. Second question is, how do our 4 centers differ? My dear parents, I'm very happy to share with you. All these 4 centers were incubated in Symbiosis Law School in Pune. All these other 3 centers were developed and mentored in the initial 6 months in terms, I mean, most of them have leaders who were trained here, who were our faculty, senior faculty members, and they carried the knowledge from here. So 80% of the standards that I told you are very much visible there. Where do we differ in 20%? One is that we have independent advanced research center where they are the beneficiaries and participants, but we lead that. Second, this law school has a dean's office. So most of the faculty, senior faculty like Dr. Bindu and Dr. Rupal are involved in dean's work as well. They can be called incognito associate deans. And with them now we have our Dr. Zadav, Professor Kshitij, Professor Vasmatkar and all getting developed as leaders alongside other 2 associate professors, Professor Aghav and Professor Shelke. So this is where we differ in terms of research output, in terms of advanced research. But essentially, there is another difference. And that difference is they give general BA LLB, BBA LLB program. Symbiosis Law School Pune gives BA LLB, BBA LLB honors program. What is the difference? In honors program, you have 8 extra courses where you have the opportunity to study those 8 extra courses in your chosen area like intellectual property or business law or international or global legal studies, for example, or criminal law or public law like criminal law and constitutional law combo. So this is how our 4 law schools differ. But I must also tell you that Symbiosis Law School Pune cannot absorb all the 20,000. So out of 20,000, we shortlist 2,000, and all the 2,000 also cannot qualify to come here. We have only 300 slots. So rest of them as second preference or even as first preference being the locals, etc., may go for any of the other 3 options available, unless you are wanting the challenge of an honors program with the challenging peer group and also luck and hard work favoring it together, qualifying in the merit list. So in case you have to compromise without Symbiosis Law School Pune, you don't have to be disappointed, because I will tell you any day I can guarantee as a colleague that all our three law schools and their leaders and faculty are equally competent, and they carry the DNA of excellence of Symbiosis and Symbiosis Law School Pune, which has been their initial incubator. Now, coming to the next question, how do I get the scholarship? We showed you, Dr. Zadhav showcased, 8 crore worth scholarship we dispersed. Now, this scholarship has got, each one of them has their own condition. Once you enter the college, you can come to our support coordinator. She will give you all the details. Some of them are Government of India scholarships exclusively for SCST and disabled students. We call them as Divyangas. And then we have scholarships which are given by our donors like alumni, etc. Then we have the Symbiosis Foundation scholarship, which is for the toppers in every year's exam and top set exam. For this year, because of the austerity measures for this batch, we have put the scholarship on hold, but within a year, we will be unholding, means opening that hold, releasing the hold, and we will continue. However, the donor-sponsored scholarship like Jain scholarship, my own scholarship, so some of these scholarships will continue irrespective of this austerity measure. So the conditions and eligibility and the competitiveness will be known to you. However, we also have merit certificates given to the toppers, gold medals given to the toppers, which are given by the university. Now, somebody was asking a question, tell me about WAT. WAT means writing ability test. It is usually an essay which is given, which is based on any of the contemporary developments. So maybe we can ask the patient rights in COVID management period. We can ask about the health law policy. We can ask you about the rights of children. We can ask you about economic liberalization and its global impact. So we give you these topics, and then you will be given 20 minutes and you have to write these essays in those 20 minutes. So you are judged, as Professor Vasmatkar already told, based on your language, on the grammar, on the facts and materials that you bring into your essay, introduction, description, conclusion, description with cases and examples and facts. So keep your general knowledge very much abreast, especially the legal developments, the fallout of various high courts and Supreme Court in last 1 year, because we have a very smart panel. So one or two questions on those will be asked even in the interview. So that's all. If you prepare for good writing skills, and if you are very much aware, make your small notes on current developments, and you are able to translate them into sentences, then those 20 marks writing ability test will be easy to you. So are they happening simultaneously, interview and writing ability test? Our current decision is, since it is a proctored exam which is happening, we will be doing, as of now, because COVID doesn't seem to show the signs of being abated. So we will be having writing ability test on the same day with extra time when you're writing your entrance test. But personal interview will be only for the shortlisted 2000. I hope I have answered your question. Somebody asked, how are BALLB and BBALLB different, which is good? Answer, both are very similar, except that in the first year and second year, and partly in third year in the first semester, you will be learning your undergraduate related humanities or business administration subject. That is the first difference. In terms of what is good, depends on what you think is good for you. One is your background. If you are 12th science or 12th commerce, it is good for you to go for BBA, LLB. You may have some initial teething troubles in accounts and business related economics, etc., for which we do the bridge classes. And usually our science students fare well or as good as the commerce background students. Then when you come to law studies, both are having same subject, same standard, same options for electives, but you may elect based on the career plan that you have, plan A, plan B, plan C, and some may want to become judges, some may want to go to foreign studies. So normally those who want to go to judiciary, public service, and study abroad, they may combine their BA or BBA, LLB along with the tracks like internship with judges, research articles, as Dr. Rupal mentioned. So this we guide you how to shape based on your career choice. So I hope I have answered your question. Both are good. The difference is only in the initial optionals that you have. And both are good as long as you build on the strengths that you have based on the specialization of your 12th standard. And now, VAT is not cancelled. The question whether VAT is cancelled, VAT is not cancelled. Somebody asked about what kind of changes this year's examination has. This year's examination is definitely a change from the last 12 years that we had, but it is very similar to last year's exam. Because as of now, we have decided for proctored exam, where the exam is happening in your house, but 1,000 eyes of artificial intelligence in the name of proctor, the boards are watching you. So if you were doing it in a center-based test, there would be center's invigilator. Here, there are invisible board invigilators. So don't try to mess with it. Last year, somebody tried to challenge by using multiple devices, keeping someone in the shadow and making them. Everything is recorded. There was one student even had the courage in our one of our sister law schools go to the high court to challenge, saying that she didn't cheat. And the high court came out with a technical cyber records, which was given by our service provider. And it went through the details of that and the student lost the case. So there are evidences, not by human agency, but by boards again. So don't try to mess with it. Be honest, be sincere, work hard and approach. There was one person who asked a question that why can't you create a study group? I mean, it will be like me revealing my own examination system. So I request you, please make use of our email lines, our help lines. If you have any doubts regarding your study groups and study methods, etc., we are not a coaching class and it is ethically conflicting if we are engaging in that. It will favor some students who are members to the study group. So sorry about that. I'll have to say no. Now, can a commerce student still opt for BALLB? Yes. Commerce student may not have background in political science, etc., but you will have to build that background. You have to have a flair for writing when you're coming into humanities and 360 degree thinking. Science student and commerce students are not used to long answers and descriptive answers and verbose way of thinking and writing. So that you will have to cultivate here, which happens with the peer group and excellent teachers. Like you have had the teachers coming and talking there with you, like Professor Kshitij, etc. So you will definitely, and Professor Arya, who is a taught law teacher. So you would definitely love learning under them and then developing these skills. How many words do the students write or type in VAT? Minimum. There is no minimum word. We would say about a minimum of, I mean, we don't qualify the person to be evaluated unless there are 100 words. And the maximum can go up to your speed and your speed of thought. But mind you, it is not the word. It is the language. It is the structure. It is the logic. It is the example. It is the facts. Writing, simply filling the pages is not going to guarantee the good marks. Can BLLB students have a corporate law career? Depends on what you mean by corporate law career. If you're working in a law firm which is organized like a body corporate with the litigation arm, with the consultation arm, with the research arm, yes, a lot of our BLLB students have gone into J. Sagar Associates and other lead law firms and even banking careers. So finally there, you know, it comes to more of that kind of legal acumen. Coupled with corporates, it can be more niche, like in the investment banking and things like that, when it is a BBA LLB student. So I hope I have answered the question. Can I share my CV and LORs with admission? When can I do so? Usually this is asked once you're shortlisted. Why do you want to put the cart before the horse? So let's wait one step at a time. Is there any role of class? Yes, if class 12 result comes, you will exhibit that percentage. As Professor Abhijit Vasanthkar said, 30 marks for the personal interview out of 5 marks are reserved for this. If the 12th result doesn't come, then we go by your 10th result. Okay. Will the classes applying for admission process One minute, you are dashing questions repeatedly and questions which are already answered. So please remember the questions which are answered, you need not ask again. What is the fee structure? It is there in our advertisement. Please go back to those. Now, please depict the chat line, please. I mean, somebody came in the this one. Maximum percentage of scholarship a student can get. if you are among the toppers in every batch, in the beginning you don't get, because this year we have put it on hold. Otherwise, you can get up to 50% of your total fees. SLAT is online. As of now, we have decided to have it online because of the COVID crisis. We should not even be asking this question till COVID crisis is over. So we have already announced. I hope you have read our announcement. It has come to you. CLAT is not necessary for admission because we have our own CLAT equivalent and our own more standard kind of exam, which suits our kind of combination of BBA LLB and BA LLB honors. Is there a common list for all Symbiosis Center? Exam is common. List we individually drop. Usually the top students inevitably apply for Symbiosis Law School, Pune. For JAG and other army field, I already told you, Mr. Zadav highlighted, you should have heard it already, that we have a separate skill center which gives orientation to judicial careers, all kinds of public service careers, and also gives our career development and professional development cell, which in other colleges is called placement cell. It gives guidance on different types of careers. For 10th, how much does Symbiosis expect? No, your 5 marks out of 30 are reserved for your 10th score. So if you have more than 90%, you get full 5. Less than that, proportionately, you lose. Numerous achievement in school life. Yes, it is good for you. Even extra qualifications are good. National and international and state awards, we give 2 to 4 marks, depending on the type of certificate that you produce. So whatever glory you may have, if you are shortlisted for interview, at that time, if you don't bring the certificate, you will not have any advantage of that. Do we have remote proctor test? I told you already, yes, that is what we are planning. We may change our plan, but it looks remote now because of the COVID crisis. IB board students can use their predictives. However, in order to confirm their admission, if they get admitted, we call it as eligibility, they will have to produce the original certificate that is given by the board. I think IB board has a very progressive way of giving this predictive based on previous year's average. We can have the confirmed date of SLAT examination once CBSC gives it clearly. The CBSC dates we have to have in hand because we don't want to burden the students, double burden the students. We want to keep at least a week's gap between CBSC exam ending and SLAT exam happening. Since CBSC did not announce the date, we are not going to announce the date. This week or next week, we will take a call on that and we will finalize. We are still hoping they will announce, and I don't think they'll be able to announce till the COVID de-peaking and clear path is laid out about the COVID crisis, because traveling is a risk now. How can we give certificate in online? You are uploading your certificate, and in the interview, we ask certain questions whether this certificate is really projecting in your personality. Is that clear? NRI admission process, we don't explain. You will have to go to, I mean, we have given you a link in our admission advertisement. Please go through that. You will have to go to the link called scie.siu.edu/in. And there you are explained the process where 10% of weightage is given to your SLAT score. And who is an NRI, means who can apply as an NRI, as an international student, is very clearly laid out. Unless your qualifying exam of 10th and 12th are abroad, you will not qualify as international student of foreign student origin or somebody holding international passport is one. Second is one who has done the 12th exam outside of India. Otherwise, you have to go through the entrance test. Now, till now, we have been talking for 2 hours. Nobody raised question except a handful. And I was answering those questions. Now, all of a sudden, same type of questions you are asking. This is, I think, last minute rush of Indian behavior. I want to, what is the difference between SLAT and SET? SET is for non-law graduation exam. It's a separate exam, which will have School of Economics, BBA, and Liberal Arts, and all our other undergraduate program. SLAT is only for our 4 law schools, including Symbiosis Law School, Pune. So if you pay one fee for SLAT, then you will have to pay different fees for the institutes where you want to reserve your chance of being shortlisted. And in that, if you want to have your chance being shortlisted in both the programs, I told you that cutoff marks can be more for BBA or BA, depending on the crowd and the intelligence of the crowd and scoring pattern. So then you have to pay separately for both the program or pay for or register for both the programs. That enhances your chances of being shortlisted. So mock test email will be given to you once the mock test date is decided. Usually mock test is conducted after the last date of payment is over. Mock test is for not every Tom, Dick or Harry. It is for those who have paid for the SLAT and their candidature. After we verify all the data, their complete registration is accepted. Then we invite you for a mock test at least 10 to 15 days prior to the main date. So be patient and wait for our call. Trust us. What types of topics are there for VAT? I already told you current topics, last 1 year major legal developments. You don't see 12th board happening soon, so let us have the entrance test on 27 June. That's a good idea, but let us take a call, because what we see is parental behavior and student behavior is that till the 12th exam dates are confirmed, people are very lackadaisical in applying for the SLAT. And we don't want to disappoint any of the students or parents who want to apply. So looking at the behavioral pattern in last 10 to 12 years, we are going to give that kind of a time to wait for the CBSC to come out with the date. I already told you classes for the same subjects are not taken together because each class has got 60 students. We give importance to groups. And in online classes, sometimes we may combine if there is a guest lecture or if there is a broader subject. When it comes to specialization, let us say media law. In media and entertainment law, the tendency is that both the BBA and BA students take it. In merger and acquisition, both BA and BBA students take it. Those are honors subjects or elective specializations. There we combine all the divisions because usually those classes are not exceeding, let us say 200, we make two divisions. I hope I have clarified that question because that question has been repeated 5 times. I think that's clear to you. We can't take common classes from year 1 to year 5 because there are some subjects which are very, very unique to BA LLB and very unique to BBA LLB. How has SLS adopted a changing pedagogy? Dr. Bindu already told. I'm not going to repeat. Please refer the webinar recording. Is there any issue if I haven't applied? No, it doesn't matter at all. It is you who has to decide. In case you change your mind, you go to an assessment person and see your personality is more suited for business or administrative jobs or managerial MBA, then you can have your option open by applying for SET as well. And if you apply for SET and you feel that, okay, let me decide about law after I attend 20, possible, you can come to our 3-year LLB program. What is syllabus for law? Already it is given, Mr. Abhijit Vasmatkar has highlighted, and in that, you know, whatever you prepare for CLAT and general law entrance examination is applicable here, which has a dabble in constitution, criminal law, law of torts, contract. No, you may lose out of 30 about 4 marks. NRI students, please go to NRI admission link, international student admission link, and see if you qualify exclusively there. As I told you, if you have not done your 10th and 12th in India and you have done it abroad, then you qualify there. And you can still do the SLAT so that for those 10 marks, you can add to your profile if there is a competition for admission. Otherwise, if those 10 marks are okay with you, if you are happy to score 90 to 95% in your 12th, then your chances of getting admission are stronger. So please approach our international office and then you do that. Then are the exams not attemptable on phones? No, we would advise you avoid phones, have backup two internet lines, two devices, because this is your telling examination. We say in law of torts, voluntary non-fit injuria, or we say buyer beware in law of contract. So if it is your right, then you have to take utmost care. Law doesn't help the one who sleeps. So I'm not going to answer those repeated questions. Is there any important question which remains unanswered? Can other members see? Who has got this Abhijit Vasmatkar on the beaming, this one? We need a larger chat line reference here. What is the difference between, that has already been told. Will SLAT be conducted in different rounds? So no, we don't do that. I don't know if other exams are held. I know that for seniors, we have the management examinations done in different rounds. We don't do in different rounds. We have phases. Examination is held only once on the designated date. And then shortlisting of the candidates and their personal interview and the scoring on the basis of the writing sample, which is provided, which is done in different phases, in the sense that different groups are called at different time. Now, most of the information is there on our advertisement. Go back there. If any part is not clear, you ask. SLAT exam will be on the basis of objective. Clearly, 150 questions in 5 different divisions, which has already been highlighted by Mr. Vasmatkar. Kindly look at that communication bulletin. Now, somebody asked whether IB student will be given a preference. No, no student will be given a preference, or no student will be discriminated. So those wrong notions that Pune students are not wanted. We have higher percentage of Maharashtra students qualifying these days. So it depends on how good the student is, how hardworking they are. Some of them might be tenuously in last 1 year, where organizers few, please pay attention. Please pay attention to mute those unwanted noises. Yeah. That is how I request you to pay attention to the objective process and respect our process and work hard to qualify. If originals are lost, duplicate, will there be any problem in admission? See, we give, as I told you, we give admission as tentative only. And the tentative admission is always looked at in terms of confirmed till eligibility is proven. At that time, we will ask for the original, we will verify. So you may take time, but we will need the proof that you have lost it. There is an affidavit, there is a police complaint, and there is also a request for replacement with the proof of communication with the board. So we go by facts and evidences. So I think most of the questions we have answered. Is there any one question which remains unanswered? Will you please be kind enough to repeat that question right now? Because some of the questions are mired in repetitive unwanted questions. Most of them we have answered in the past. Is there any chance that boards and SLAT might clash? No, we are responsible to see that they don't clash. And moreover, we hold the exams on a weekend so that that day no exam paper is there. So you may have a little tension, but if you prepare well in a strategic way, it will not be difficult. Is hostel compulsory? No, it's not compulsory. For girls, it is compulsory. We make it compulsory. Still, there are some girl students who have food issue and other things where parents may shift to Pune. We don't compel them. But you have to give valid reason. The fear about pursuing this course, fear is valid. But sometimes fear prepares us for a stronger crisis. Therefore, validate that fear, take counseling, and these times are bad, so the fear is very natural, but it is not difficult to cope up. Let me tell you, students who have qualified here in the top range have not done well down the line because it went to their head and they took it easy. Students who have qualified here in the second or third merit list but have gone on to become gold medals by sheer hard work. I gave you the example of the boy who qualified to Linklaters. He cultivated a personality. And as he spoke, you would have realized the politeness, the humility, the clarity, sheer 24 hours kind of hard work sometimes. So it don't have these irrational attitudes, hearsay, somebody else's opinion, sometimes diffident and discouraging environments. Just go by what your heart says and by your determination to do the best once you get the opportunity. So somebody was asking, and the question has been answered by Professor Jadhav, that eligibility is 45% for SC/ST. Eligibility is 45% for general candidates of the open category and 40 for SC/ST. This is as per the Bar Council rule. What kind of NLU should we opt for? That's a very subjective question. We would not like to answer this question because we don't compare oranges and apples, because when you compare, both of them are fruits. And depending on your your purse, depending upon your health needs, depending upon your readiness to digest, and the dreams that you build, the opportunities that you have, the choice is yours. You are the consumer. Any other question? Which campus is there in the background? That's our university campus in Lovelace, where you all will be going for your health retreats, medical examinations, sometimes even the leadership training in your cabinets. So out of 2,000 students, 250 students have an opportunity sometime or the other in their career to go there as trainees. Rest of the time, everyone has the opportunity to go during their life cycle once a year for sports and other activities, for festivals and things like that. Exams are not attemptable on the phone because we request you to have high bandwidth. Can I apply for SET? Yes, but there are many students who do a trial round in their 11th and 12th. So I can't advise that ethically because it is like soliciting a wrong kind of candidate. But it is your choice. So how do internships work in SLS? How do they work? We have, in the COVID crisis, we provided for 400 internships in the college where students worked as researchers, assistants, etc. And then we also managed the internship for all the students. So we go by three ways. One is students themselves choose by cold calling, means by finding the addresses and emailing their CVs, by building such CVs. Second is by their own family and friends connections, networking at their competitions and social gatherings, etc., conferences and other things. Third is college provides for internship for the students who approach them, because all the industries write to us, approach us. So daily I have 4 to 5 requests coming. So multiplied by 300, it will be about 1,200 requests. So our placement cell allots them to students. What we do is we float it around to the eligible students as the company asks. Sometimes they say only fourth year. Sometimes they say only fifth years. Sometimes they say anyone above the third year. And then the students apply. Then we send it to the company. Then the company shortlists and says whom they want as interns. So this is how it goes. Purely merit, transparent process. If anyone is unhappy, they can come and ask for explanation. And we have that process of right to know and right to information. I think I've answered all the questions which have come, including the latest question on the fear, etc. And some questions have been answered by my colleagues. So thank you very much for your valuable time. We wish you all the best. We will come back to you once again once we zero in on the date, if there is a change after the CBSE announces its dates. Till then, please keep yourselves busy, work hard, think positive, combine and harmonize your schedules and time between your qualifying 12th exam as well as this. Don't just overdo any of this. Don't be obsessed with any of these. Every opportunity is a good opportunity in life. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you very much. And I also thank my team members for wonderful contribution and our special stakeholder like Rahul Kothari, Mr. Anup sir as a parent, and all my students who came online and shared their genuine experiences. I'm sure all this will enable you to make the right choice and good decisions and valid kind of self-introspection and very fair chance and trust that